Hey guys, Dagan from PMTV UK here, winner now 2016, and I'm here with a legendary Ade from Orange. How's it going, dude?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. You having a good show?
Really good. You don't mind being called legendary, do you?
Oh, I'm fine. Anyway, new for the show.
Right.
Cool. Yeah, we got the four-stroke, the Orange four-stroke, 300 and 500.
Nice.
Yeah. Same output stage as the OB1.
Very nice.
Yeah, so it's a Class 8B output stage, different pre. What I've done is I've put a four-band parametric on.
Very nice.
On the front end, plus minus 18 dB. Yeah, really pokey. There's no decoupling caps between the stages, so the noise floor is really low.
Nice.
And the signal is really clean. Then you got like a compressor on there, which is foot switchable, and then your output level, you know. 60 dB pad for active instruments, you know.
Yeah, cool.
They're the frequencies for the EQ.
Nice.
So you can pretty much dial in anything you think you're going to want on,
for any bass.
So it's really versatile in that way.
Nice one.
You can pretty much get any clean bass sound, you know, out of it.
Nice.
Just from that EQ. I just wanted something that was like a blank canvas. It was actually designed for an artist.
All right. And you.
I can't. But I ended up releasing it anyway.
Yeah, cool.
Because it was, I just liked it. I thought, actually, it done just got a long stiff at NAMM, you know.
Yeah. Is that a foot switchable compressor on the front?
It is. That's defeatable with any latching foot switch, you know.
Sweet.
I mean, that works like a tree. You can use it as a little boost, you know.
Yeah, of course, man.
So obviously we've got the Tiny Terror, which is discontinued. Yeah. Discontinuing Tiny Terror, giving it a Viking funeral. So what we've got is a stainless steel chassis, all handwired point to point, and the cabinet is two 10-inch golds, Celestian golds.
Very nice.
Open back.
Sweet.
You know, it's a cab I've been using myself for years, you know, so I thought, well, it'd be nice to
offer that
cab, you know.
Sweet.
But I mean, after those are gone, there's only 110, they're limited edition, so
right,
you know, they're being snapped up. And I mean, they're not cheap, but they're being snapped up.
I think we've got a few coming in the store as well, so they'll be cool.
Okay, also new for the show, we've got the two-stroke boost EQ.
Nice.
Which is a clean boost, 12 dB on this, the oil control. If these are in the middle, it's at unity, and if that's down, it's at unity.
Right,
yeah.
Cool.
But there's a high and low parametric as well, plus minus 18 dB. So you can make a treble booster, a mid booster, or if you've got an amp that's got a good amp sound going that you like, but you want something to clean it right up, you can EQ by subtraction
and
almost make it sound like an acoustic if you want, you know, and then just defeat it to go back to your amp sound. So it's kind of a cool. God, I just wanted to do something a bit different, you know.
Yeah.
And ABY boxes have always, the problem with them is the ones that work well are really big, and need power supplies.
Yeah.
Not everyone likes to. Sometimes people just like to throw something with a battery in it, like if it's a quick setup, you know. So this will power on a 9-volt battery, and it only draws 12 milliamps, so it will last.
Sorry.
You know.
Yeah.
So it steps it up to 18 volts inside if you put 9 in, or 24 volts inside if you put 12 in. You know,
cool.
Run on 12, switching silent, and the output's transformer coupled on the B, and buffered on the A. So they're both buffered. They're really low impedance, and then if you're using an amp setup where one of them's out of phase, you've got the phase button as well.
Really clever bit of kit, man. Really clever.
And it kind of, the way it works is, it's really simple. There's only one LED on there, so what I've done is, that's A, that's B. If you hit both, it goes blue. If you go hit both again, it goes back to what you had running. So if you're on there, it'll go back to, or if you're on there, it'll go back to that.
Yeah.
You know,
so a simple solid bit of kit, but with loads of intricacies inside.
A lot of the small ABY boxes don't really work that well, you know, and the impedance is wrong to yeah, the transformer's going to put a big roll off on both ends. So I've EQ'd the transformer on that. So, I fed it antidepressants, you know. Yeah, I gave an unhappy face, a smiley face, and it kind of ended up with a line, you know. And that is new for the show. Ah, the old bass.
The old bass, of course, man. The basses. Everyone's excited about these guys.
Yeah. So, basically, I wanted something affordable that was classic, four strings, get the kids back into rock and roll again.
Yeah.
That was the idea, you know. So I wanted something traditional, you know, doesn't sound a million miles away from a good P bass. Pickups moved forward 8 mil to where it would be on something like a P bass, you know.
Nice.
Volume tone.
What's the body wood?
It's, I can never pronounce it. You're going to have to look on the website for that.
Yeah, the details at the bottom of the website page anyway, so.
Yeah, sure. So, yeah, we wanted something sort of classic looking.
Yeah. The binding up the neck looks great. The binding around the sunburst
looks great too. Yeah, I mean, the lighter colours, like the white and the orange, don't need the binding.
Yeah.
But when Cliff wanted to do a sunburst, I went, well, I think to make it look right, it's going to need, like, the black one as well. Black guitars look good with binding because it shows the body shape. Yeah. They look good on stage. If they haven't got binding and they're dark body shapes, you can't make out the body shape. So it's kind of a bit nondescript what you're playing. Some people might like that, but I don't. So, I sort of went for the binding on it. Yeah. Well, I'm glad I did because it does, it does the job.
Yeah. All set off nicely with a tortoiseshell pickguard as well.
Yeah, and I think they're very affordable. I think in US they're less than $500.
Wow, man. Cool.
You know.
We'll have the pricing for the British stuff on the links to the page as well, dude.
Yeah. Okay.
Excellent, man.
I think that's it.
Good to go. It's been a pleasure, as always.
Have a great show.
Cool. You too. Enjoy the rest of the days.
Yeah.
Thanks. Thank you.